When I got sober, I was a bit older than Brittany. I was 29. And Christmas morning before I got sober, I had been in an all-night bender. I woke up that morning. Now, this is the mind of an alcoholic. I woke up that morning, Christmas morning, and I thought, you know what? I can't do this anymore. I'm going to kill myself today. I'm going to do it today. And what I did was, I thought, I made a plan as I'm getting myself together. I thought, I'll go down to Tower Bridge in London, which is the one that goes, you know, that one, and I'll swan dive to my death. I don't know how to swan dive, but I was going to do it. And I thought, by showing, you know, by doing this, I'll show them. I didn't even know who they were, but I was going to show them. That, I was desperately confused and desperately twisted and turned upside down by whatever the hell was going on in my head.
I went to rehab with a lot of doctors and psychiatrists. And the more intelligent you think you are, the harder it is to let go. You think, I've got a solution. I'll just drink a little bit. It's like saying, I'll just partially circumcise myself. I'll be fine. Mm. And then you have to go, nope, you lose. You can't do it. You need help. And at that point, that's the beginning.
My father was an alcoholic, and I can still remember as probably a ninth grader, just waiting at night, not being able to go to sleep at night, waiting to hear a car come up, and you know what tires sound like when they're moving on gravel. You can hear the crunching, and that was, even though I didn't particularly want to hear him come in his drunken condition, I felt relieved that at least he was home.
Because we have these things called blackouts as alcoholics. It's not really blackouts. It's more like sleepwalking with activities. Kind of strange. I believe it's your conscience going into a witness protection program. It's your conscience going, you're about to fuck a hobbit. I gotta go. Good luck.
So now he's back in our life again because he gets remarried. And he actually met the woman that he eventually remarried, or the eventually married, through Alcoholics Anonymous. And I can remember getting a telephone call from the police department in Portland, Oregon. My father and his wife had been found in the garage of their apartment, or the home they had rented, with the garage door closed, and they had left the car running. They both committed suicide because they just couldn't go back through another bout of heavy alcoholism. They knew they were going down that path.
Fortunately, I didn't go too far down the skids. I have 15 years and I finally came to my senses, and I'm glad I did. It was a long time ago, and you know, I see people still carrying this monkey on their back, which, I mean, you think, I mean, half the world has been created through intoxication in a way.
Right.
Which is extraordinary, creative power, because it is. Drink up, but it does. The tragic thing about it is that it's got the scorpion tail. It finally turns around, yeah, and bites you in the ass and kills you.
I wish that the media, whether it's through advertising or television or movies or whatever, would stop trying to say it's okay for everybody. Because there's, how do you define and decide when it's okay for you and not okay for somebody else?
But I really want to study this whole thing of drinking, getting drunk, and people saying that they're having a good time. Because if you put on a good suit or whatever, and you say, I'm going out to have a good time. But some people announce it. I'm going out because I deserve to go out, and I'm going to get drunk because I deserve to get drunk.
in my life, alcoholism was not a joke. It was not something that you could say, well, gee, you remember when your dad used to do this? It was not a joke to me to be embarrassed to have my father be with me when he was drunk. Maybe some of my friends would laugh about it, but I can tell you, my two brothers and my mother, living in a basement in a North Dakota city because that's all we could afford, because my father had made a decision. Whether he had any choice in that decision, I'm not smart enough to understand how strong the drive was to have him make the decision. But I will guarantee you that decision was not a joke in our family.
Now, all of us in America and in Scotland and anywhere I've ever been in my life, everybody knows an alcoholic. They're either, you know, they've worked for one, or they have one work for them, they have a parent or a sibling or a child. Everybody, there's not one of us. It does a friend, God forbid some of you poor people are married to them. You know what it's like. Now, I have found this. You can't beat it with money. If you could beat this rap with money, rich people wouldn't die. You can't. There's, for me, only for me, and I only speak for myself, so I've got to stress this to you, I have found that the only way I could deal with it is find other people who had similar experiences and talk to them. It doesn't cost anything. It doesn't cost a thing. And they're very, very easy to find. They're very near the front of the telephone book. Good luck. Thank you.